Hello everyone. Hamad, are you there?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Hamad, why are you not attending the class on a regular basis?
Sir, I just missed the last class because there was some emergency in my home.
There was some emergency.
Yes, sir.
So Hamad, make sure that you attend the classes on a regular basis. Otherwise, you won't be able to understand anything.
Sure, sir.
Okay. All right. So, guys, in the last session, we were discussing this chapter, final account. And in the last session, we have started the concept of balance sheet. So, before proceeding further in this chapter, we will first of all revise everything. Then we will continue. Just give me a moment. Okay. So, in this chapter, we have understood the meaning of the financial statement. Financial statement or the final account, basically, comprises of three statements that include the trading account, the profit and loss account, and the balance sheet. First of all, we have started understanding, we have learned about the trading account, wherein I have told you that trading account is a statement that basically shows the gross profit or gross loss generated by a firm during the period of 1 year. Okay. Then we have done few questions based on the trading account, and after that we have also understood the concept of profit and loss account, wherein I have explained that profit and loss account is also a part of the final account that indicate the net profit or the net loss generated by a firm during the accounting period. And on the profit and loss account as well, we have done few questions. And after that, we have in the last class, we started the concept of the balance sheet. Okay. So this is the format of the balance sheet. And we have done few questions based on the balance sheet. So I think we did this question in the last class. And I think I have given you one question as homework. I think I gave you this as your homework, Halima, Steve. You guys, Halima and Steve, you guys did the homework? Halima, any doubt with the homework question? Halima, are you there? Halima. No answer. So, I presume that you didn't do the homework question. So let's do this in the class. All right. So Hamad, in the last class, we have did this concept of balance sheet. You will be able to understand the concept of balance sheet through this question. Okay. Just try to focus because you have skipped the classes. So you will be having some problem with this topic. But if you try to pay attention a little, then I'm sure you will be able to understand this. Just give me a moment. Let me draw the balance sheet. Okay, so this is the format of the balance sheet. This is the, are you able to see this, everyone?
Yes, sir.
So Amma, this is the balance sheet. So on the in the balance sheet also, we have two sides, the liability side and the asset side. Okay, so the liability sides contains all the obligations of the company, such as we record on the liability side, we record the value of the capital. On the liability side, we record the value of the creditors. On the liability side, we record the value of the bills payable, and all other liabilities. All the liabilities are recorded on the liability side. And asset side consists of the following item, like building, furnitures, machinery, debtors, bills receivables, and all other short-term or long-term assets, short-term or current asset or the fixed asset, or all are kept under this category, under the column of the asset. Okay, so let's do this question. First of all, the first item given in the question is this one. So the first item given in the question is cash at bank and cash in hand. Okay, so Ahmad, tell me, what do you think? What are cash and bank? Cash at bank and cash in hand. What do you think? These are liabilities of the business or the assets for the business?
So I can't see the screen properly because today there's a different view.
You're not able to see the screen properly?
Yes, sir. It's a little blur because today there is a little different view of.
Let me share my screen with you guys. Actually, I have changed my screen. So the orientation is different this time. So might be because of this, you guys are facing difficulty. Just a minute. Let me share my screen with you. Okay. Is it visible now? Is it clear now, Ahmad and everyone else?
Yes, sir.
Better? Okay.
Yes, sir, better.
So the first item is cash at bank and cash in hand. So what do you think? What are these items? Cash at bank and cash in hand. Do you think these are liability of the business or the assets for the business?
They're assets.
Assets. So we will be recording it on the, on which side? We will be recording it on the debit side or on the asset side of the balance sheet. Okay. So yes. Just a minute. Okay. So I'll be writing here cash in hand. And there was one more item, cash at bank. Okay. So cash in hand was how much? It was 4,800 and 1,200. So 4,800 and 1,200. Is it clear, Ahmad?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now let's move to the next item. Okay, next is furniture and fixtures. Furniture and fixtures. What do you think? What are furniture and fixtures? Furniture and fixtures are what? These are also
asset.
Correct. So furniture and fixtures having a value of 7,500. These will be recorded on the debit side, furniture and fixtures. $7,500. Okay. Next item we have is debtors, 80,100. Again, debtors are
asset.
Debtors. 80,100. Okay. Next item in the question is closing stock, 70,000. So Hamad, closing stock is also an asset. So closing stock will be recorded on the asset side. 70,000. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Next item in the question is motor car. So motor car is obviously an asset again. Motor car is an asset. So on the asset side, 40,000. Next item in the question is buildings, 1,50,000. Again, building is also an asset. Next item in the question is plant and machinery, 1,20,000. So plant and machinery. 1,20,000. Tell me, is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, after that, we have the next item given in the question as the value of the bills receivable, 4,400. So bills receivable again, because it is an asset. So bills receivable on the asset side. Bills receivable is 4,400. All the items are assets. Okay. Next item we have got is investment. Again, investment is an asset. Investment. And the value of investment in the question is 20,000. Ahmad, you are writing this, no? Along with me?
Yes.
Please keep on writing. After that, we have the value of the drawings. So let me share you guys just a minute. Now you can see the last item on the left side of the statement is drawings 6,000. Are you able to see this?
Yes, sir.
So drawings, how do we treat drawings? Let me show you. Value of drawings are written on the liability side. And this is how it will be written. We will go to the liability account. First of all, we will write down the value of the capital. Value of the capital will be increased by the net profit. Whatever the net profit that we have generated, we will add the net profit in the value of the capital. And out of that, we will reduce the value of the drawings. Out of that, we will reduce the value of the drawing. So value of drawing is 6,000. We will be writing it here. Okay. And after writing the value of the capital, after adding the value of the net profit and reducing the value of drawing, we will be writing the final value in this column. Is it clear, Ahmad and Halima?
Yes, sir.
Okay. All right. So just a minute. Let's find out the value of the capital in the question. Are you able to find out the value of the capital in the question, Ahmad and Halima?
Yes, sir.
Tell me. 3,32,300, right? And the,
yes,
the net profit also given in the question? Is there net profit also given in the question?
Yes, sir.
Tell me how much it is?
57,200.
Correct. 57,200. So capital 3,32,300. Just a minute. 3,32,200. And it was 300, no? Just 300. And how much was the profit? 57,200. 57,200. Okay. So we will add 57,200 in 3,32,300 and we will reduce the value of the drawings. So let me find out the value. 3,32,300 then plus 57,200 and minus 6,000, we will get 3,83,500. 383,500. Is that clear, Ahmad and Halim?
Yes, sir.
Any doubts?
No, sir.
No doubt.
No doubt. Moving on to the next item in the question. Yeah. So next item in the question is bills payable, 3,200. So we will be writing it on the liability side, bills payable. Okay, so bills payable 3,200. After bills payable, creditors is there in the questions, creditor 61,300. So we will be writing the value of the creditors also on the liability side. 61,300. Then we have value of loans, 50,000. Loans will also be written on the liability side, 50,000. And after that, we have the value of the capital. We have already treated the value of the capital on the, we have already recorded it on the liability side. So this is it. We have recorded all the values. Is there any doubt with any item, Ahmad, Halima?
Sir.
So now what we will be doing, Hamad, we will be totaling both the sides, and total of both the sides should tally. Both the sides should automatically tally. So both the balances as balance on the asset side and the balance on the liabilities side should get tally. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
When you will total both the side, you will get the balance. Just a minute, let me show you. Yeah. So when you will solve it, you will get 4,98,000 on both the sides, debit side as well as on the credit side. So this is the solution of the question. 4,98,000 on the asset side as well as 4,98,000 on the liability side. Tell me, all of you, is that clear?
Yes.
Okay. So kindly note it down or take the screenshot. Then we will move to the next question. Let me know when you are done.
Done.
Okay. So this time, this is the question. And in this question, we are not required to prepare the balance sheet. Balance sheet is already prepared. It is already given in the question. Then what are we actually required to find out? We are actually required to find out the value of the fixed asset, then the value of the current liabilities and the current assets and the working capital. All of these things are required in this question. So can any one of you tell me what are the items that will be included in the fixed assets? What are the items that will be included in the fixed asset? Anyone? Halima? Tell me what are the items.
Current fixed asset will include land, plant, furniture.
Land, plant, and furniture. Okay. Land, plant, and furniture. Perfect. And also goodwill. Goodwill are also fixed assets. These are intangible but considered as fixed asset.
Okay,
isn't
sir. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
So, in order to calculate the value of the fixed asset, we will be adding the value of the goodwill, then land, plant, and machine and furniture. Okay. And other than these items, all other items on the asset side will be considered as the current assets. Other than land, plant, furniture, goodwill, every item is a current asset, like stock, debtor, prepaid expenses. All these will be considered as the current asset. Is it clear, all of you?
Yes.
Okay. Then, Hamad, is it clear for you also?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, then we have to find out the value of the current liability. So tell me, what are the items that will be included in the value of the current liability? Anyone? Tell me, current creditor or long term liability or a current liability? Creditors are
current.
Correct. Similarly, expenses accrued is a current liability. Bank overdraft is also a current liability. Interest on loan is a current liability. Getting my point, trade creditors are current liability. Expenses accrued is a current liability. Bank overdraft is a current liability. And interest on loan is a current liability. So then what are long-term liability? Long-term liability will be capital and the long-term loan. These are long-term liabilities. Is it clear, Hamad? What is the meaning of the current liability? Current liability basically means the liability that is required to be paid by the business during the period of one accounting year. Any obligation that is required to be paid off within 1 year period is considered as the current liability. Is that clear, Hamad, Halima?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Okay. And similarly, what are current assets? Current assets are those assets which are not kept, which can be easily converted into cash during the period of 1 year. Which can be converted into cash within a period of 1 year are considered as the current asset. Okay. So we have find out the value, we have find out the fixed asset, then current asset and the current liability. Is that clear till this point? Any doubts?
No, sir.
No doubt.
The value of the working capital. So any one of you knows the formula for the working capital? Let me tell you, and please write it down, all of you. The formula for the working capital is the is current asset minus current liability. Formula for calculating working capital is current asset minus current liability. So whatever the difference between the current value of the current asset and the value of the current liability, it will be considered as the working capital. Is that clear, all of you?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes.
So all of you kindly calculate all these value, find out the value of the fixed asset, find out the value of the current asset, then the value of the current liability and working capital also. So I've already told you what are the items that will be taken into account while calculating fixed asset, while calculating current asset and current liability. So I just want you to add those values and let me know the final answer. Is that okay, Halima, Hamad?
Yes, okay.
Yes, sir.
Please solve it. Let me know the answer. Done, all of you. Fix this. Tell me the value. Anyone, please tell me the value of the fixed asset. Value of the fixed asset. Halima.
It will be
80,000.
Yeah, it is. It will be 80,000. Correct. And the value of the current asset, 48,000 plus 36,000 plus 400.
84,400.
Yes, 84,400. Perfect, correct. Then the current liabilities. Current liabilities will include 42,000, 3,200, 4,800 plus 1,000.
51,000.
71. 71 or 51?
51, sir.
51 it will be. I think that is correct. 42 plus 3, 45,200 plus 4,800 Okay. 51,200 I think is the correct answer. Yes. No. 51,000 it is given in the solution. So current liability is 51,000 only. Hamad, you are getting 51,000.
Yes, sir.
Now after that, we can find out the value of the working capital, current asset minus current liability, that is 84,400 minus 51,000. Okay? Any doubts, guys?
No doubts.
Okay. Let's move to the next question. And now we have, as we have understood the concept of trading account, then we have, after that, we have also covered the profit and loss account, and then we have also understood the concept of the balance sheet. Then I think we can do one question wherein we need to prepare all these statements. So I'm showing you this question, and in this question you are required to prepare all these statements. Like, you are required to prepare the trading account as well as the profit and loss account and the balance sheet. Okay, everyone, is that clear? So items, yeah, that belongs to the trading account will be taken into consideration while preparing the trading account, and item that should be recorded in the profit and loss account, we will be writing it in the profit and loss account only. And there are certain items that will be recorded in the balance sheet only. So balance sheet items will be taken into balance sheet only. Okay. So I'm giving you 15 minutes to solve this, because it will take some time. And let me also prepare the format of all these statements. You guys start the question. Anybody having any doubt? Halima, Hamad, Steve?
No.
Okay. So first of all, start preparing the trading account, then prepare profit and loss and the balance sheet finally. Okay, so in this question, the first item that is given in the question is capital. So tell me, capital will be recorded in which account, in which statement? Trading account, profit and loss account, or the balance sheet? It will be recorded in the balance sheet, correct. So the value of the capital is 3,60,000 that we will be recording in the balance sheet. Okay, so value of the capital, 3,60,000. As we know, value of the capital is always written after adjusting the value of the profit. We will be adding net profit in this. that will be determined after preparing the profit and loss account. And we will also subtract the, if there is any drawings, and then whatever the value remaining, that will be recorded here. Okay, is that clear? No? All of you? Is that?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Now, next item in the question is the machinery. So machinery will be recorded in the, tell me,
machinery balance sheet.
Balance sheet on the asset side, correct?
Yes.
Machinery on in the,
yes sir,
on the asset side, 70,000. You guys keep keep recording it. I'll showing you the solution after I'm done. If you have any doubt, you can ask me. Then after that, we have sales. So sales belongs to which statement? Trading account, profit and loss account. Tell me. Sales belong to profit and loss account. Alima, what are you doing? Ahmad, sales belongs to. Sales will be recorded where? Sales are recorded in the trading account. Na? Sales will be recorded in the trading account. Is that clear? All of you?
Yes. Credit side.
Okay, so.
Sir, buy sales are recorded. Oh, yeah.
Sales will be 8,20,000 on the, on which side? On the debit side. Sorry, on the credit side of the trading account. Sales 8,20,000 on the,
and sales return of
the trading account. Okay. Then we have, okay. So we have sales return as well. So we will write down the value of the sales after adjusting the value of the sales return. So let me correct it. Sales is 8,20,000 and value of return is 10,000. So the final value of sales is 8,10,000 only. Is that clear, everyone?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
So this is how we will be writing it. Then the next item in the question is purchases. So tell me, purchases are also item of the trading account, right? So purchases will be written on the debit side of the trading account. Purchases are given as 4 lakh, then purchase return is 5,000. So purchases will be written here. Four lakhs. And return, we will have to reduce it. Return is 5,000. So 3,95,000. Is that clear, all of you?
Yeah.
Then we have the value of the capital we have done, machinery, sales, purchases. Stock on 1st April 2018. So opening stock will be written. Where we will be writing opening stock?
Trading.
Oh, trading account again, correct. So opening stock in the trading account. Opening stock 1 lakh. Okay, moving on to the next item. Next item in the question is drawings. So tell me, Amar, drawings will be recorded in which statement?
Tell me. Drawings will be recorded in the balance sheet.
Correct. So balance sheet. We will be reducing 4,000. 40,000. After the drawing, we have the wages. So tell me, wages of rupees 1 lakh, it will be recorded in which statement? Wages, 1 lakh.
In trading account.
Trading account, correct. On which side? Debit side.
Wages. Debit.
Correct. Wages, 1 lakh on the debit side. Next item is carriage inward. Tell me, Hamad, carriage inward will be recorded in which statement?
That will be recorded in the profit and loss account on the debit side.
No, carriage.
No, sorry, that's carriage inward. Carriage inward will be recorded in the trading account side on the debit side.
Correct. Carriage inward is 5,000 on the debit side. Next item we have is salaries. Tell me, salaries are written on, in which account? Salary.
Profit and
loss on the debit side.
Perfect. Salaries. 60,000. Okay. After that, after salary, we have general expenses of 20,000. Tell me, in which account I will be writing general expenses? General expenses in which account? Trading account or profit and loss account?
Profit and loss.
Profit and loss account. Correct. General expenses. Ahmad, are you clear about this?
Yes, sir.
General expenses of 20,000 in the profit and loss account. Okay. Next item is rent. Tell me, rent. Again, sir, it is an indirect expense. So rent of rupees 3,000 in the profit and loss account. Okay. Then we have purchase return is already treated. Debtors of rupees 3 lakh. Tell me, in which statement? In the balance sheet, right? Debtors will be recorded in the balance sheet, na?
Yes.
Ahmad and Halima. Ahmad.
Yes, sir.
3 lakh debtors will be recorded in the balance sheet. Then we have cash. Tell me in which account? Cash. Again in the balance sheet.
Balance sheet.
40,000. Ahmad, you are clear about this now?
Yes, I'm okay.
Okay. Then we have carriage outward. Tell me, carriage outward. Carriage outward. Which account?
They're in the profit and loss account.
Finally, carriage outward. Carriage outward 20,000 in the profit and loss account. Okay, then we have advertising. Advertising again, it is a profit and loss account item. Advertising. Value of advertising is 20,000. So 20,000. After that, we have the creditors. Creditor is an asset or a liability, Amar? Creditor is an asset or a liability?
A liability.
Yes, creditor are liabilities. So I'll be writing it here, creditors. 50,000. Okay, so we have recorded all the items as given in the question. Only one item is left to be recorded. See. We have recorded all these items. Only the closing stock is yet to be recorded. Tell me, closing stock will be written where? In which account? Trading account, profit and loss account, or the balance sheet?
Trading.
Trading account, correct. And also in the balance sheet. So closing stock are recorded at two places. One at in the trading account and then there, then in the balance sheet. Is that clear, all of you? So we will be writing the value of closing stock. In the closing stock will be written here. Closing stock will be written here. Value was 2 lakh. So, and also this will be written in the trading account. Closing stock in the trading account as well. Ahmad, clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now finally we will now balance both the sides. We will find out the balances on in every account. So first of all, we will total the trading account, debit side of the credit side of the trading account will be added first. So 8,10,000 plus 2 lakh, it will be 10,10,000. Right? Is that clear, everyone?
Yes, sir.
And from 10,10,000, we will be reducing 3,95,000. Just a minute. 10,10,000 reduced 3,95,000. 95,000 minus 1,00,000. Then again minus 1,00,000 and 5,000. So the gross profit should be 4,10,000. 4,10,000 is the gross profit. So gross profit will be 4,10,000. Is it clear, all of you? 4,10,000 is the gross profit. Now we will tally both the sides of the trading account. So both the sides should have the same balance, 10,00,000 and 10,000. Is it clear, all of you?
Yes, sir.
Are you able to see this solution now?
Yes.
Yeah.
Now tell me, gross profit will be taken forward to which account?
Profit and loss account.
Profit and loss account on which side?
Debit
side or the credit side? Credit side, correct.
Yes,
correct. Yeah. We will be writing by gross profit. All the item will include the two. These are all two items. And here also we will be writing on the debit side item, we will be using two, and on the credit side item, we will be using by. So gross profit in the profit and loss account will be 4,10,000. Okay,
net profit will be 20,000.
Net profit will be
24,000.
24,000 is the net profit. Okay, so to net profit. All right. Now we will tell you both the sides. So 4,10,000. And also on this side, 4,10,000. Okay. Tell me, net profit will be carried forward to which account? Tell me, on which
balance
account?
Sheet.
Balance sheet, correct. So we will be writing net profit 24,000 here. Okay. So let's now add all these values. So 3,60,000. 3,60,000 plus 24,000 and minus 40,000. 3,44,000. So sum total on both the sides should be how much? 3,44,000 plus 50,000. It should be 3,94,000. Are we getting the same answer, everyone? I think there are rising a difference.
Yes, sir. I guess it should be.
We are getting the different answer, no?
Yes, sir.
1,000 plus debtor is 3,00,000. Let me check. I think I have committed some mistakes somewhere. Let me check.
Sir, its net profit is 2,40,000.
Net profit is 2,40,000. No? Okay. That is why. So I by mistake I have written, I think Halima have told me 24,000 it is. So 2,44,000. Okay, I think now it will be correct. Let's total it now. 3,60,000 plus 2,00,000, 5,60,000 and 6,00,000 and 10,00,000. 10,00,000. No. 3,60,000 plus 2,40,000. Minus 40,000. So 5,60,000. And then we will total this side. How much is the total? 6,10,000. 610,000 is the total of the credit side. Now we will total the debit side. It will be 3 to 5 lakh, 5 lakh 7, yeah, 610,000. Both side are having equal balance. So balance sheet is tidying. This is it. Is it clear, all of you?
Yes, clear.
Any doubts?
No.
So you need to write it down, or you're done with this?
Done.
Okay, good. Very good. Any doubts with the question, Muhammad and Halima?
No, sir.
No doubt.
Okay, let's move to the next question. Okay. So guys, this is the question, and I'm giving you this as your homework. We won't be doing this because it will take around 15 minutes. So I'm giving you this as your homework. In this question also, you need to prepare the trading account and the profit and loss account and the balance sheet also. All right. Will you be able to solve this question, Hamad and
yes, sir.
Halima? Any doubt?
No doubt.
Okay, so this is it for today's session, guys, because this will take some time. So we won't be doing any more question. We will be discussing about the final account in the next class as well. So this is it for today's class. Thank you so much, all of you, for attending this session.
Thank you, sir. Mm-hmm.